Hi everyone. So I wanted to talk to you a bit about why I think Supree Leader Snoke is Darth Plageuis. I'm going to start first of all by giving the major reasons as to why I think Snoke is Darth Plagueis, and then I'll finish by discussing the minor reasons why I think Supree Leader Snoke is Darth Plagueis. Well, first of all, the novelization of The Force Awakens describes Plagueis as being aware of the past to a great degree, and the fact that he saw the rise and fall of the Empire. Andy Serkis has also confirmed that he is quite vulnerable but powerful at the same time. He's also said that he's a newly introduced character. Many people see this as a counter-argument as to the argument that I'm putting forward, but the fact that he has said he's a newly introduced character doesn't actually counter the fact that Snoke could be Plagueis. No one ever saw Plagueis. We only ever heard about him. So the fact that if Snoke is indeed Plagueis after all, he could still be newly introduced in this series of films and still be Plagueis, even though he's been mentioned before. He has never been properly introduced before, at least not face to face. The second reason is that he's badly wounded when we meet him in The Force Awakens, which it would make sense for these wounds. They appear life-threatening, life-changing. You know, he's badly mutilated, and it could very well be that these wounds were as a result of an assassination attempt. And after all, as Palpatine says in Revenge of the Sith, while seducing Anakin to the dark side at the opera, he says to him that Darth Plagueis was killed in his sleep by his apprentice. And now, in the Revenge of the Sith, Palpatine never actually explicitly said that he was his apprentice, although it was confirmed after the film came out officially that Palpatine was indeed Darth Plagueis' apprentice. So these wounds that we see, these scars that we see on Supreme Leader Snoke, very well could be the result of an assassination attempt by Palpatine, his apprentice, which means that he is Darth Plagueis. He's also very powerful on the dark side, as is evident, and Plagueis was said to be very powerful with the dark side. Another major reason as to why I think that Snoke is Plagueis is that before The Force Awakens came out, even before Disney acquired Star Wars, there was one version of Darth Plagueis, and one only, that was official canon, and that was Darth Plagueis as a Mun. The 2012 novel Darth Plagueis had, which is now non-official, non-canon, described Darth Plagueis as a Mun, which is a species with an elongated head, and clearly not what Supreme Leader Snoke is in the films. This was a major counter-argument, but if you go onto Wikipedia and you search Darth Plagueis, you'll see that there are two versions of Darth Plagueis. There is the canon version and the Legends version. The Legends version refers to the Darth Plagueis as per the novel, the 2012 novel Darth Plagueis. While the canon version doesn't say much about him at all. It just says that he's male, doesn't have any pictures of him. And it just says all that we know from the films, that Palpatine was his apprentice, that Palpatine killed him, and that he could influence midichlorians to create life. All the things that we know from the films, all the limited information that we know from the films, that is what we know from the canon, the official version. It's interesting that they don't have any pictures in there, because obviously that would be a giveaway. Okay, so another reason as to why Supreme Leader Snoke, it would make sense for Snoke to be Plagueis, is that if you think about it from J.J. Abrams and the writers and forget his name now, the writer on Lawrence Kasdan, the writer on this film and Empire Strikes Back and all the other ones, they would have sat down and they would have said, right, Palpatine is dead. How do we make a good, worthy, bigger, badder villain of the Star Wars universe, the follow-up from Palpatine. It doesn't make sense to have some new irrelevant bad guy. You want to link all the films together because they are one story, make no mistake. So it would make sense to have, you know, if you say, look, Palpatine was the bad guy of the classic trilogy and indeed the prequel trilogy, how do we get a villain which is worse, you know, more threatening, more powerful than Palpatine? Well, logically, you take his master. His master, yeah, was said to be dead, but what if he wasn't dead? What if, after all, he did cheat death, as Palpatine said that he could? Well, as Palpatine said, he could save others from death, but not himself. Maybe Palpatine was played for a fool, and Snoke really did survive after all. So that makes sense, having Plagueis as the bad guy, for that reason, for all those reasons that I've put forward. Those are the main reasons as to why I think Snoke is Plagueis. The minor ones are, first of all, the bridge scene. If you put two and two together, the scene on the bridge with Kylo Ren and Han Solo. I'm not spoiling it now by saying, I mean, I don't need to say what happens on the bridge, even if you haven't seen it. But when Han Solo says to Kylo Ren, when Snoke gets what he wants, he'll crush you. Kylo says, no, the Supreme Leader is wise. Which is an interesting point. It harkens back to Revenge of the Sith, when Palpatine asks Anakin, do you ever hear the tragedy of Darth Plagueis the Wise? Clearly, not just from this, but also from what I've read about Plagueis, even in the Legends version, Plagueis was known to be wise. He was known for his wisdom. So that could be a subtle hint to the fact that Snoke is Plagueis. Another reason, which many people regard as a major reason why Snoke is Plagueis, I regard it as a minor reason, is if you listen to the music in the scene between Anakin and Palpatine in Revenge of the Sith, when they listen to the opera, when they're sat down, and Palpatine introduces him to Darth Plagueis, and you compare that music with the track called Snoke from the Episode VII soundtrack, the two are very, very similar. To illustrate this point, I've been playing both Snoke and Palpatine's teachings from the Revenge of the Sith soundtrack. I've been alternating between the two, and if you weren't actively thinking, you probably wouldn't have noticed that they're actually two different tracks. But they sound very similar. Many people have interpreted this as blatant evidence. However, I know that John Williams, having listened to many, many of his scores, likes to use very similar themes. Now, John Williams, I don't want to get too much into John Williams, but John Williams, for me, his themes, for specific, you know, the really iconic themes from Indiana Jones to Harry Potter to Star Wars are brilliant. But, you know, from the opening credits, the classic, the Indiana Jones and Harry Potter and Star Wars, all that is they're really distinct from one another, really unique. But the stuff in between, you know, the typical dialogue scenes, background music, they can be quite similar. I wouldn't hold your breath. I would take that with a pinch of salt. I do. Because there have been various other scenes in The Force Awakens which sound almost identical to other scenes from other Star Wars films, so I wouldn't read too much into that. However, it could also be direct, a direct reference to the fact that Snoke is Plagueis. So that's why that's a minor reason. Another reason why is that J.J. Abrams said that Snoke, as we know him, was almost a female, rather than a male, and I mean, that, if that is true, if they were considering Snoke to be female, if that were definitely true, then that pretty much rules out the idea that Snoke could be Plagueis, because Plagueis was definitely a male. But we can't forget the fact that Abrams actually said with Star Trek Into Darkness, when there were rumours that Khan was going to be in the film, that Benedict Cumberbatch would play Khan, he denied these rumours. So maybe this whole female, the idea that they were nearly making Snoke a female, is just nonsense. Maybe they made that up. Because if they don't throw in, you know, things which could be counter-arguments to people putting forward the idea that Snoke could be Plagueis, then it's obviously, it just makes it more obvious. So they need to make people a bit more uncertain, they need to cloud these rumours in mystery so that it's not obvious, because if it is, there'd be no discussion at all. So thank you very much for listening. I hope you liked the video. If you have any ideas or anything you'd like to share, please leave it in the comment section below. If you like the video, please subscribe. And may the Force be with you.